Hey, what's going on, guys? And welcome back to a brand new Hytale video. For today's video, I want to go over the different factions and kind of the different races that have been revealed in Hytale. So far, there's actually quite a few. In a later video, I'll go over maybe more animals and stuff. But for this video, I want to focus on the different factions that we know of so far. There could be more that they add. These are like the main factions that will be in the game. Some might be evil and you have to fight against them. You might have to help them. Starting off, we have the iconography research on the Hytale website, some of the concept art they have. And so we have a couple runes which represent a few different factions. So far, you have the Trorks, and I'll go in more depth to these factions, but you got the Trorks, you got Farrans, you got Fawns, and Slothians, and I'll go over these. So starting off, Trorks, these guys are probably going to be like the main faction that you have to fight against in the first part of the story, as you'll be helping the Quebecs, who are also another faction. But Trorks, they will be the main guys that you'll be fighting in Zone 1, the Emerald Grove. Along the lines of the story, you'll have to help the Quebecs maybe take back their land or take back their home from the Trorks. Next up is the Quebecs. They didn't have a rune on the iconography part, but right here it says engraved stone with simple wind rune. So maybe just like the Farrans, they will have they'll be kind of represent the wind and the freedom. So just like the Farrans, I believe that the Quebecs will be another friendly race, another friendly faction that you'll have to help out. They're by far everyone's favorite faction and race in the game. Everyone's loving them. They're also going to be in the first part, so probably in the beginning of the story, they'll be the guys who will help you along in the beginning. Next up, I wanted to go over the Farran. Now, the Farran have their own rune right here. As you can see, they have the Farran right here next to the Sand Empress. Right here, we got the Farran, and these are kind of like a fennec fox. They live in the Howling Sands, the second zone, the desert zone. So these are probably, once you help the Quebecs and stuff, you'll travel on to the Howling Sands and you will help the Farran fight back against the Skerriks, which are another race. I'll go in depth next slide. But the Farrans represent the freedom bracelet, and they wear this on their arm to remind themselves of their past slavery they had, that the Skerriks held them in slavery and forced them to do work and whatnot. So maybe any creature that kind of represents freedom, I'm assuming that freedom is the good side, the light side. These are the guys you're going to be helping, and you're going to be fighting against the evil, which is the void. But yeah, they're looking pretty, these guys right here, they're looking pretty cute, and then they probably grow up and to become shamans, or maybe they'll have a different race, kind of like a shaman, they'll have warrior types and whatnot. Right here, they kind of live in these hide and bone cabins and tents, so these are going to be in the Howling Sands. Next up, we have the Skerriks, which are another race. These are going to be the evil main faction, main race that you'll be fighting in the Howling Sands in the desert. It's like a weird mix. These are kind of like a weird desert bees. That's what they remind me of. But you know, you got like the brood mother, which kind of like the queen bee. You got different warrior wasp, Skerriks. You got different larvae. You got the egg sacs, which probably you might have to go in and kill off or burn the egg sacs so you can't spawn anymore. They also live in these bases that basically, they forced the Farran to build and forced them to build, and they have different prisons. So right here, you can see, you know, this is a prison, so maybe you have to go and help some Farran free the rest of their kind from these prisons. So as you can see, prison cave entrance, you got cells underneath. Right here, this is a sand palace, so this is maybe where the brood mother lives, and she's like one of the bosses that you have to fight. But this is in the second zone, the Howling Sands. Now, next up, we have the Slothian race, and nothing's really been shared about them yet, but there's a part in the trailer where there is some guy who looks kind of like a sloth standing up fishing, and it's a part of, I'll show it right now, and I'll slow it down for you guys and zoom in, and maybe that's a Slothian race. I don't know where, either they're part of Zone 1 or maybe Zone 4, I can't really tell. There'll probably be another race. I'm assuming they'll be friendly, because it seems like these more animal-type races will be more friendly towards you. So who knows? Nothing's really shared about them yet, but I really want to know more. Next up, we have Fawns, and I couldn't find anything on these guys, like literally anything at all. I did find one thing, but I don't know what this is. It is an interest. This is environment and creatures. It's a part of the concept art, And right here, I'll zoom in for you guys. There is a tree looking guy. But he's controlling wolves. I don't know if that's a faun or another boss. If you know from like Greek mythology, fauns are kind of the half goat, half man creatures, and they like to play the flute and stuff. So I don't know if the faun is something like this, or is it actually going to be something like a faun from Greek mythology. I'll pop a picture up of a faun, but from Greek mythology. But I don't know. Let me know down in the comments what you think. I really don't know. And then we also have, you know, the human race, which is the only playable race in adventure mode that I know of. But if we look at one of the pictures, you can actually see a lot of different creatures. So maybe you can play as different factions. Like you have a Trork right here, you have Quebecs and stuff that are watching the video from one of the pictures taken from the website. So I don't know if you can do that in multiplayer, but I'm assuming in single player you have to play as a human. There's also another race that I wanted to talk about. I don't know, this is like a race or a faction, but these are the Outlanders. Nothing's really known about them except they have bases, and they kind of are looking kind of evil. I'll zoom in for you guys, but nothing's really known about them, but these are like different outposts. Maybe they are just humans who have turned evil, or they are a race unto themselves. Also, we have a couple more. Nothing's really been shared about these races. Firstly, we got the skeleton race, and this is like another faction that it's probably going to be not as big as the Trorks, but you'll probably find them in Zone 1. You got like a skeleton, you got the wizard skeleton, you got the frozen warrior, so these are probably, you know, the skeleton. These are going to be guys you're going to be fighting along the way. Just kind of like a small little race, small little faction you'll be fighting. You got different archers. These guys are probably part of Zone 1. You got a soldier from Zone 4. So these are actually guys you're going to be fighting in Zone 4. The wizard part of Zone 1. You got the sand warrior who'll be part of Zone 2, the Howling Sands. And then you got Zone 3, a frozen warrior part of the Bora. So, you know, that's going to be pretty good. They're probably those guys, you know, you're just fighting along the way, kind of like just the skeletons of Minecraft, you know. Not a main focus, but those will be those guys that are always there, you know, always got to keep fighting them, which is no big deal. Also, right here, if we zoom in, here's one of the, like a more concept art kind of a thing, but right here we have another faction or race, and these are like the Mer people, and there was another image of them in the water. If we go into a screenshot, and I'll zoom in for you guys right here, see, we next to the sharks, we have, if you zoom in right in the middle, we have a merman, a merlock. I don't know, I'm assuming it's a merlock, but there's probably more. I'm assuming there's got to be more. There's probably not many big emphasis on a couple of the other ones. Like, could we count the Void Eyes as a type of race, a type of faction? I would assume so. So right here we have the Void Eyes. These are going to be probably the main bad guys. And they remind me of that kind of scout drone from Star Wars, you know, where they're on Hoth and they got to watch out for that big black droid. So these are kind of like the eyes of the bad guy. These guys are going to be flying around. And here's another picture right here. They're going to be flying around looking for you. They might attack, but they're probably going to, if they see you, maybe they'll send back a signal to a couple other like bad guys, and they'll start coming after you. So see, this guy's hiding right here, and they're in the Bora Zone 3, and the Void Eyes are circling around looking for you. So, you know, you got to watch out for those guys. Those guys are going to be definitely very evil. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know down in the comments if you know of any more races that I missed. I'd really like to know. And then I'm sure they'll have a blog post later on, probably in the next few months, talking about it, or at least going more in depth about, like, you know, the different factions, different races of the game. So yeah, that should be good. Also, subscribe for the channel, because I have a couple more videos coming out in probably the next few days to a week, and then a week or so from now, I have a big video that I need to start recording probably the next few days, but it's going to be the lore, the story of Hytale, and what I think kind of the main story will be, in kind of a storytelling format. So, you know, look out for that. Yeah, but thank you so much for all the support. I'm now at like 30 or I'm like at almost 40 subscribers. That's actually crazy. It's been so fast. So thank you so much for all the support on my videos. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace out. Thank you.